Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I have another favourites video for you all. This one is for the month of March, obviously, because the month of March, depending on when I upload this, has either just passed or is just about to end. Either way, let's get into the favourites. And I also have one not so happy product. I don't think that's ever happened on my channel, but now there is a not so happy product. Okay, so you guys might not know because I don't think I've mentioned it in the video before, but I have super, super, super dry, super, super, super chapped lips. And I have recently discovered the Carez Jasmine Lip Butter. It looks like this, and it's just a super rich and creamy lip balm that I apply to my lips when I feel like it needs that extra bit of hydration, and I just love it. So, yeah. And the jasmine scent smells like cotton candy, which is amazing. Okay, so my foundation favorite for the month of March was the Bourjois Healthy Mix Foundation. I did film a first impressions of this, but I'm not too sure if I'm gonna upload it, only because I'm not 100% happy with it, but I don't know, we'll see. I really, really like this. It looks so, so, so luminous and so perfected and just healthy, as the name suggests. It's so nice. I would say you would need to wear it with a primer though, but oh my god, my sheep are going crazy. Don't mind them. Yeah. Bourjois Healthy Mix Foundation, would definitely recommend that. It's absolutely beautiful.
I think one of my sheep is calling its little sheep friends, and it's like, meh. And then my other friend's like, meh. And then like they round together, like, meh. Whatever.
I've really been into contouring this month, hence two contour products. One is a liquid contour. This is the Illamasqua Light Liquid Foundation. Color LF335. I basically bought this because it was $4 at the Illamasqua counter and I was like, I need a darker foundation, so I picked this up and I really, really do enjoy it. But basically any darker foundation should do the trick for contouring. I have it in my cheek bone area today. So my next favorite is the Illamasqua Disobey Powder Blusher. This is like a beigey brown. It is matte. And it's just so, so beautiful. It looks so natural as a contour. I would recommend this if you were of light or fair skin tones. Maybe not medium. I don't know. You would have to try it in the store. But I'm of fair to light skin tone and I find it just beautiful. So yeah, definitely check that out if you haven't already. Keeping with the cheek theme, I'm going to be mentioning my favorite blush of the month. This is the Balm Instain Long Wearing Powder Blush in the shade Argyle. It looks like this. It's just a super, super pretty light pink. I don't know, I'm so shit at describing colors, but whatever. The only thing I hate about this is the packaging. It's like paper, so it picks up stains so easily, and I just hate that. It's like my biggest pet peeve. I hate when like my products are stained. Ugh. Okay, next is the Stealer in the Light palette. I absolutely adore this palette. I've had it for a while now and I haven't really gotten into it much until recently, but I've been obsessed with this sunset shade. It's so beautiful. It's just like so, so, so gorgeous. I don't think the camera's going to do the color justice. I love the shade Bliss, Bubbly, Bare, Gilded Gold. I love them all. But yeah, just so beautiful. And it also has the iconic kitten from Stealer as well. So if you're looking to try out Stealer, I would highly, highly, highly recommend this one. Especially because you can try their iconic color as well as all the others. I think the pigmentation of these is absolutely amazing. Okay, Benefit Stay Don't Stray. This was my love like a few months ago and I just forgot about him. And then I seen him in my collection again and I was like, I forgot about you. Oh no. And then I brought him to the top and I've been using him every single day. Days that I wear makeup at least. I basically don't use this as an eye primer, I use it as a concealer because it's very, very pigmented. It's kind of like MAC Pro Longwear, but I find it a little bit better and a little bit easier to use on the daily. It's got the doe foot applicator with the new packaging and I just like apply it underneath my eyes and it gives me decent coverage, and if I want more I just use another concealer. But overall, I've loved this for the month of March. Okay, next favorite is the Maybelline Great Lash Lots of Lashes. I recently hauled this and I haven't opened it until the month of March. And honestly, guys, like the wand looks a bit funky, like it's a bit of a triangle wand or like, yeah, triangle wand, like a cone or something. But honestly, words cannot describe my love. It's just like, it's a super wet formula, so if you don't like that, you may not like this, but like, the wand is so amazing. Like, the shorter ends are so amazing at getting your lower lashes, and also like, the little giant coney bit like here is so good at separating, and the short bits are so good at volumizing. I absolutely love this. I don't know how it works so well, but I absolutely adore this. Okay, last product before I move on to my not so happy product. This is MAC lipstick in pink plaid or pink plaid or however you pronounce it, but it is a matte finish and the color just looks like that. I'll do a swatch on my hand. So the color just looks like that there. Excuse those swatches on my arm. I went shopping before, but yeah, it's just like a, like, sounds so weird, but like a dirty blue-based pink. It's really, really, really pretty. I don't have it on today, but I love this lipstick. It's so, so beautiful. So if you haven't seen it, go to a MAC counter and swatch it. It's beautiful. Okay, so time for the not so happy product. I just want to say why this product didn't work for me and why it's a not so happy product. Basically, I've worn it a few times throughout the month of March, and like with foundation, it is a primer. I'm going to say that now. It is a primer, and I would wear like, say, L'Oreal True Match over the top. I wore my MAC Studio Fix over the top. What else did I wear over the top? I wore my Bourjois one. I wore a few other foundations over the top. And basically, all of them did basically the exact same thing. My forehead, all the foundation wore away, and I wasn't even wearing a hat or a beanie. And then basically all foundation rubbed off my nose. And then like here, it all just broke down and was like all like chunky on my face. Not just once, like this was like various days throughout March this happened to me, and it was disgusting. And the only thing that I've changed was this product. This is the MAC Prep and Prime Skin Base Visage. I recently hauled this, and I did use it in one of my videos actually. And it's perfectly fine if you only want a primer for say 2 or 3 hours, it's perfectly fine. But if you want an all day primer, this is not for you, my dear. Like, no, stay away. This is a not so happy product for me. Maybe I got a bad one, I don't know. I might need to talk to some MAC people and see their experiences with it and how they use it, because basically I just apply it like how I apply any primer. Pump some into my hand, rub it between my fingers, distribute it around my face, put my foundation over the top, done. So yeah, maybe I'll see what they recommend for that. But basically that was a not so happy product for me for the month of March. Quite sad actually, because I never have not so happy products. Like, what? Where did this come from?
I need to stop being sad about that primer. Go away. Whoop.
Okay guys, that's the end of my video. I hope you guys enjoyed my favorites. What were your favorites for the month of March? I'd be more than happy to know them, so definitely comment them down below so I can read them and maybe buy them and try them. And yeah, so definitely let me know, and I will see you next time. Bye.